and heaven do exist, and they are warned by every prophet. Isa alayhi salam, Jesus peace be upon him, once passed by a group of 4,000 women from the children of Israel. And he saw them that they had placed their heads down in misery and their faces had gone pale. He asked them, why are you scared and pale? They said, we heard about hellfire and we heard how intense it is and we are scared. We are scared because we heard that there is no coolness in it and no drink of water to quench our thirst. Isa alayhi salam then advised them, if you obey me and follow my way, then you will be saved from hellfire. So every prophet, every messenger cared for his people. And Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because he came to all of mankind, all of the people, he warned all the people from it unanimously and without any differentiation. Brothers and sisters in Islam. Brothers and sisters in Islam. Ummah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, listen carefully. Jahannam is real. Umar ibn al-Khattab radiyallahu anhu used to say, if I were to see with my eyes right now hellfire in front of me, my belief in its existence would have not changed. I already believe in the existence of hellfire as if it is in front of me now. It's as real as can be. Do we believe in the existence of hellfire like the reality? As you see your own hand, as you see your person next to you, as you hear your words being spoken, Allah says in the Quran, كَلَّا إِنَّهَا لَحَقٌّ مِثْلَ مَا أَنْتُمْ تَنْطِقُونَ. By Allah, without a doubt, it is true and reality. It is the real thing. Just as real as your speech and hearing. That's how real it is. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created Jahannam with thousands of levels. And it has seven different doors. And each door is lower than the other. Each pit is worse than the one before it. The surface of Jahannam is the easiest. And what is easiness of Jahannam? The most easiest punishment that anyone will ever receive, let's use another phrase, the least painful punishment that anyone can receive in hellfire, as the Prophet ﷺ said, is a man who will be placed in there. He has the least amount of bad deeds of the people, the inhabitants of hellfire. Two coals of fire will be placed underneath the soles of his feet and his brain will boil forever. Naam. That is the least punishment in hellfire. So what about the ones even worse and worse off than that? Imagine, my dear brothers and sisters, imagine, if you can, that you are the size, your back tooth is the size of a mountain. What would that make the size of your mouth? Then imagine that if that's the size of your mouth, what would be the size of your head? We'll end it now, inshallah, brothers and sisters, with that note, because the time of the adhan has now crept in. And inshallah, we will continue next week, same time at 7 o'clock. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده وحبيبه وخاتم رسله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Brothers and sisters in Islam, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. It is my privilege once again to sit here before you to discuss and to learn together and share teachings of our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, teachings of what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent to us, teachings that will make us enter Jannah, which is our objective, and teachings that will save us from hellfire, which is our fear. My brothers and sisters in Islam, we have spoken already a long series about the signs of the last hour, followed by the hereafter, followed by heaven. And today, inshallah, we start with hellfire. Last week, I did speak about hellfire only a little bit, but because of the restraint of time, we couldn't go and cover a lot of its sessions. So today, inshallah, I am going to start again from the beginning. And I would like to begin from where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in the Quran. بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم واتقوا النار التي وقودها الناس والحجارة fear a fire whose fuel is rocks and human beings. So the fire of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a scary fire. It's a fire of horror, a fire of pain, a fire of torture. It's only consumption, it's only food. The way that it grows and lives, the way that it quenches or satisfies its hunger, is by eating rocks and human beings. In fact, Jahannam, hellfire, is extremely hungry right now. That every day it calls out to Allah and says, "Oh my Lord, my corners have eaten me away and my hunger is starving and I have nothing to fill me." Allah says to her, to Jahannam, "Be patient. I shall fill you with human beings, all of those who disobeyed me, and from the jinns until you are satisfied." And for those of you who recall when we spoke about the hereafter, we spoke about Jahannam, how when it is prepared, it begins to scream out and yell with monstrosity, like a lion or a beast that is starving, and it has a carcass in front of it. How does it rush to it? Jahannam begins to eat away, and Allah puts more of its inhabitants, more of the disobedient ones and the disbelievers into it, and hellfire begins to get greedier and greedier and hungrier because hellfire grows when it eats. Just like when you feed fire in this life, it grows. Jahannam also grows and says, "Give me more, give me more." Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran about this instance in Surah Qaf, "A'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan ar-rajim, bismillahi ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, yawma yaqunu li jahannam hal imtala'ti wa taqul, yawma naqulu li jahannam hal imtala'ti wa taqul hal min مزيد." Jahannam shall be questioned by Allah, "Are you now full? Are you now full? Are you satisfied?" And Jahannam will reply continuously, "Is there more? Is there more?" Until finally, as in the Sahih Hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, which is in Sahih Muslim, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then places his foot into Jahannam. Without description, my dear brothers and sisters, I make a note, without trying to imagine or describing Allah's features, but we accept them as He described them to Himself, without an image, without a description, without a similitude, without an example. He places His foot into hellfire, and hellfire shrinks and says, "Ya Rabbu qattun qatt." Oh my Lord, it is enough, it is enough. And this is how He calms hellfire down. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created hellfire.